Hello and welcome to Lisa's Stamp Studio. My name is Lisa Curcio. Today is Monday, May 17th, and the year is 2021. This is a YouTube live streaming event, and I am so glad that you're here with me. Whether you are here watching the replay, or you're visiting my channel for the first time, or you're here with me live, thrilled that you've been here and you're coming here to watch tonight's demonstration. Boy, do I have a card for you tonight. I want to look at the title to this card name because it's a mouthful. It is a triple cube pop-up card. It is a wow, and I've got a real wow for you when you see how it fits in the envelope. This is a 3D card that they're going to keep on display forever, I think. In addition to tonight's card that I'm going to be demonstrating for you, I have two other samples to share with you for a total of three cards. Now, before we get started, there's a couple things I want you to know about for the live stream, as well as if you're here for the replay. First and foremost, when tonight's live stream is finished, you're going to find a link down in the video description below the title that's going to lead you over to my website and to this. This is the project sheet for tonight's project. It's very extensive, and it's going to include all the cutting dimensions and the supplies for the projects, not just the one I'm demonstrating, but for all three projects. And I've got an added bonus in this one for you. I'm turning it to you so you can see it. I actually made you a cheat sheet template for this project to make it super easy for you to recreate at home. That's going to be available after the live stream. The other thing I want to let you know about is Gina Hawley. You'll see Gina's name here in blue, and she is my YouTube moderator. She is also my daughter and the sales and marketing director here at Lisa's Stamp Studio. She has been stamping since she's 5 years old, and she's all grown up and married now. So trust me when I tell you, she knows all about Stampin' Up! Products and stamping, so she is more than capable of answering your questions. She's here to answer those as well as provide you with links, so feel free to interact with her because, quite honestly, you came here to watch me stamp, and it's impossible to keep up with all of your comments, and I'm very cognizant of your time and attention. And then finally, we would love to have you interact with us. So whether you are here for the live stream or you are watching the replay, please sign into your YouTube account, which is your Gmail address. That will allow you to comment or chat, and we would love to hear from you. I come back and I read every single comment. I think we're all set. What do you say I turn the camera down and we'll get started? Here we go. I would love to encourage you to share tonight's video with your stamping friends. You can also pin it to Pinterest, put it on your social media platforms. It's the highest compliment you can pay me. I am going to start with my paper trimmer. Now, one thing I want to tell you about my paper trimmer right off the top of the bat is I absolutely love this, and not because I sell it in my online store at lisastampstudio.com, just like all the other products. It has an extendable arm, which is going to be really handy tonight, but this clear cutting guide is the bomb. I'm going to tell you that right now. It houses both the scoring and the cutting blades, and they navigate up and down out of the way, which means you can keep them on the track. You don't have to fuss with two products, meaning a scoring board and a cutting trimmer. So this is going to do double duty for us tonight, and that's going to be really, really important for tonight's card. Now, the triple cube pop-up card, by no sense of the means, is brand new, but I'm going to teach you a cheat sheet way of making this card so you can do all the cutting and scoring in one time while you're right here. This piece of cardstock is the brand new in color called Polished Pink, and I absolutely love it. It is cut 8 inches by 8.5 inches. This is the 8.5 inch way. I made myself a little arrow because, you know, they're very closely related in size, so I wanted to make sure I got that right. What we're going to do is we're going to do our score lines first. Super duper easy, and I do want to call your attention to this. Remember what I said in the introduction? There is going to be a very extensive PDF tutorial here with all the supplies and cutting dimensions, and that template is going to be there for you after the live stream. So the first score line is going to be at 2 inches. So I'm aligning this up here at the top. Love that straight edge because I can't do anything straight. So here's my 2 inch mark, and I'm using that light blade to score, and I'm coming straight down. Let me slide this up a little bit for you. Then we're going to move over to 4 inches, and we are going to score again. And then 6 inches, which is all the way over here. I don't know if you can see it or not, but there's a little tiny arrow there. Really easy to see when you're in person. So 6 inches, love that, because if you've got this closed all the way, which I do, it's right up against that edge, 6 inches. And then we need one more. So here's where that extension arm comes in. Love it because you don't have to worry about it bowing. It goes all the way up to 17, just after 17 inches. That last one is coming in here at 8 inches, and then we're going to score. All the scoring is done for all the pieces. That is the best part. Now, watch what I'm going to do. I'm going to open up that door. I'm going to rotate the paper a quarter turn. I am going to close that door because I want to close that arm just so it fits in your camera view a little bit better. The score lines now are horizontally. We're going to make two very simple cuts. Let's open this up. The first one is going to be at 2 inches. Again, lining it up here. Remember, this is for scoring. So I'm going to move that up and out of the way. But here comes my cutting blade. So that's 2 inches. Let me go ahead and move that. And this next one's going to slide over to another 2 inches. So these are super, super easy cutting and scoring dimensions. So 2, 4, 6, 8 going this way, and then 2 inches going the other way. That is going to give you all the pieces you need for this amazing 3D triple cube pop-up card. Super fun. I mean, this is a mind-blowing project. They are going to love this. All right, so let's talk about how we're going to put this together. You may choose when you make this at home to put all your panels on while it's flat, but I'm going to share the Lisa way with you, and by no means is this the right way. It's just the way I do it. And of course, you're going to tweak this to do what's comfortable for you. You're going to notice that the score lines are here. And the very first thing I'm going to recommend that you do is that you reinforce those score lines with your bone folder. Anytime you are working with a 3D paper project or a fun fold, those reinforced lines are super duper important because you want your card to fold and stand nicely, especially in this case because it's a 3D. All right, so we've got this one here. That half inch strip right here is where we're going to put our adhesive. And this is my silicone craft sheet. I cannot live without this product. The reason I love it is because that liquid glue, hot glue, and adhesive will not stick to it, which means I don't have to worry about being a little extra excited and getting it on my work surface. It will come here and it will rub right off. So let's go ahead and let's just add our adhesive right along that half inch strip. And if you've scored it and cut it right, watch, you're just going to fold one of those edges in and you're going to close it in on itself while it's flat. And then look, we have our cube. All right, so let's go ahead and set that off to the side. And you'll recall that we had these two other strips. Just like before, you're going to want to go ahead and you're going to want to crease up on those. Now, while I'm doing that, I want to make sure I tell you that you should head over to lisastampstudio.com. Right next to that shop button, you're going to find a tab there that is labeled rewards. And I offer very exclusive and generous ordering rewards to all of my customers in several tiers. So go check those out. And while you're there, don't forget to check out my very extensive PDF tutorial library under the classes tab. That extra half inch here is also very important because that's going to close up these smaller pieces. Now, you might be looking at this thinking, there's no way all this is going to come together and this is going to really make a card. And Lisa, it's not going to fit in an envelope. Oh, I got my envelope all ready to show you. You are going to fall in love with this. This has quickly become my new favorite fun fold. All right, the next thing I want to do is I want to give you a little tip. I like to take the raw edges where they're sealed. Now, this one happens to be really kind of pretty, but some of them usually aren't. You know, sometimes they're just hanging over a little bit. And I like to mark the ugly side with my pencil. So I'm using my Bic pencil number 2. You'll find this under the shop tab under my craft room favorites. I love this ultra soft lead. I'm going to put the word B here on that ugly tab because I don't want this showing from the front. Because if you're like me and you don't cut and score perfectly, we can hide that to the back. The next thing we're going to do, believe it or not, is we are actually going to assemble this triple cube next before we decorate it. I find it's easier, and I know you're probably thinking, oh, why would you do that when it's already a 3D? Well, watch, I'm going to explain. So let's go ahead and take that silicone craft sheet once again. Remember, we put B here for the back. I've got my adhesive here, and then we're going to cover this. Now, I'm using the Stampin' Seal Plus. It is very, very strong. It comes out in small tabs, but don't let that deter you. Now, the most important thing you need to know about this cube is it needs to go on the diagonal. So you're looking for this diamond shape. Don't do it straight. I've made that mistake. So you're looking for the diamond shape. Then you're going to push it flat. Do you see how I've just done that? And you're going to lay this down. Remember, this is going to be the back. So it's going to be the back bottom. So I'm putting the B here at the very bottom, and I'm lining up that raw edge to that crease line. And then I'm just pressing this in place. Now we're going to do the exact same thing with this. Let's go ahead and put our adhesive here. And then what we're going to do is the exact same thing. I'm taking this and I'm flipping this so that my back is going to be down here at the bottom. And now what you're looking is to butt up these two centers together. You can kind of see where it's creased here from that cut line. And you're lining up the bottom and you're going to press that in place. And then watch what's going to happen. You see how it's flat? It's going to pop down and it's going to pop out. Now, the one nice thing about beautiful cardstock, like we sell in our online store at Lisa's Stamp Studio at Stampin' Up!, is the high quality of the paper. So you don't have to worry about this getting really flimsy and collapsing. The colored cardstock is just fantastic for this. I do have two other samples. The thick basic white is going to work really good for your white bases for this because it is a 3D card. Now, watch what we're going to do next. The very next thing I decided was to gussy up those panels. Now, the great thing is I got all the cutting dimensions for you, so don't you worry. I've got some really pretty designer series paper here. This is from the Brights Assorted 6x6 package. And you'll notice that there's one design on one side and another on the other. There are several different patterns for each color in that color family. Love that because it's assorted. Now, I did this one with you right now. We stuck those together with a little basic black. If you're ever struggling on what other complementary color you can use, I want you to remember black. It makes every project pop. So you're going to need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is a great project for your scrap designer series paper. You know those little pieces you don't know what to do with? Here we go. Watch what we're going to do. So let's start with one of these. I'm using that silicone craft sheet just to keep my work surface nice and clean. And we're going to add some adhesive to the back. Remember I told you this is very, very strong. Do you remember our cube card? Okay, watch. Because of all the fancy score lines, we're actually elongating it now. So one of these is going to go here. Do you see how I left that little margin of that polished peak around the outside? Yeah, that's really important. And while I really didn't want you to have to watch me put all of these on one by one, we got to because I have to construct the card so you can actually see how it's put together. Now, I want to recall two things to you. This is going to be the top and these are going to be the front. In my case, I decided to add designer series paper to all those panels. And quite frankly, once you cut one side, you can go ahead and cut all the others the same size. Super duper easy. And like I said, great way to use up all those scraps, right? So we're going to go ahead and add this one here as well. Just looking to leave a little bit of that margin of color because we got the fun part coming up. We're going to decorate. So here's one more panel. Now, some of you may be wondering, should I do all the panels all the way around or on the inside of the cube? And if you want to, you absolutely can do that. Just make sure you don't adhere these together so that you can get to the inside really, really easy. And then here is our last one here. So many variations for this card, and this is why I love it, because it gives you lots and lots of creative freedom. There's no rules. You can decorate as much as you want. Now, while that looks really long, hang tight with me. We're going to do some other fun stuff. So let me push this off to the side for just a minute. And I've got some scrap basic white cardstock here. Actually, this is the thick basic white. And you know, whenever I say the word thick, it's because I'm going to be doing a little bit of coloring. And don't worry, I did most of this ahead of time. You're not going to have to watch me. But I'm bringing in the Memento Black ink pad. And this is a water-based ink because I'm going to add a little bit of color with my Stampin' Blends. Now, I've pulled out this fascinating flower, and it is from a brand new stamp set that I want to share with you. It is called Color and Contour, and I think it may be a little overlooked because just looking at it, you might not think it's too impressive, but oh my goodness, you're going to see a lot more of this here in alternate samples and upcoming live streams. But I love the fonts, the mixed fonts, and I love the ease of this because guess what? If you don't want to color it in, you don't have to. And if you love to color it in, you can. That's what we're going to do tonight. This is also offered as a bundle, which means there's a coordinating die. Do you see that little black dot right there? Well, I want to give you a cheat sheet that is going to really, really help you. Let me show you something. These are the coordinating dies, and I pulled out the one for the flower. These scalloped frames in themselves are worth their weight in gold. They are all stitched. They come in graduated sizes. They're a wow. Add them to your wish list. You will not be sorry. That scallop border right here across the top, fantastic. Now you may be looking at that black background, wondering what that is. And if you click on Shop Craft Room Favorites in my website, you're gonna find that these are the ultra thick magnetic sheets. And I found these new thicker ones that are 10 times better than the old magnetic vent covers. Go check those out. But I took the die out, and I'm going to tell you, I struggled because this is not symmetrical. So let me show you. I took a Sharpie marker, and I'm talking a blunt Sharpie marker. You're not going to take something pointy. Let me just pull it out so I'll show you. I took my Sharpie marker and I made a little tiny dot in one area. That dot tells me that that's going to be at the top of my cardstock. All right, so there's my dot. I'm going to stamp my flower. What I did then is I fussed and mussed with this thing to figure out how it went. And I thought, I'm only doing that once. I'm never doing that again. So when I found out where it went, there you go. You can see it lines up. You know what I took right there? You can take another Sharpie marker and you can make a dot. Or, sorry, Gina, I stole some nail polish of yours a long time ago. And I made a little tiny dot on there and I let it dry. I found that the nail polish held up very well over time and it doesn't rub off as easily as a marker does. This is going to ensure me now that I don't have to fuss with this to figure out how this goes because it's not symmetrical. That is just a great tip for you when you're at home so that once you make the indentation in these and you make that little mark, you are set to go. So I'm going to tell you right now, we're going to make some flowers. So I did one, two, don't you love that whimsical? Three, four. Oh, are we going to be able to squeeze it in? Probably not. That's okay because I got another piece of paper. And I did five and six. I know you're probably thinking, no way. But remember, when it's your card, you can do whatever you want. Then I decided it needed some leaves. And I want to show you this in the stamp set. The leaf in here is very, very whimsical. It's kind of got like a squiggly thing off to the side, which I love when you're building, okay? But I wanted to use it independently. So I thought, okay, well, we're going to improvise. Don't be afraid to use your stamps in a way they weren't intended. So I'm going to do one, two, three. I did a bunch of these, okay? You kind of get the gist, right? All right, so let me clean off my stamp just off camera. And then I am going to, well, you know what? I'm going to stamp one more thing. I pulled out the words from that stamp set that says you're absolutely amazing. And I'm going to put that over here. All right, so now we've got our greeting. And the reason is because I'm going to use one of those dies for this greeting as well as I am for the flowers. Now, I pulled out the die already, and that's going to fit beautifully here. Now, you might not think that's going to fit really well, but it fits perfectly. And then, of course, you can go ahead and color these first or die cut them first. Entirely up to you. That's just your preference. But the thing I want to tell you about is because there are separate dies here, you could put these on your die cutting platform all at the same time. Now, let me show you this. This product is the bomb. It's also one of my craft room favorites. I just pulled off a small piece. It's the Post-it labeling and cover-up tape. So many of you have told me that you have fallen in love with this tape, so I'm just sharing it with you if you're brand new here. Once you have your die aligned on where you want it, all you have to do is simply just hover over the die. And I lost my dot. Doesn't that just figure when you're all watching? I'm busy yakking away. Here we go. And then you're going to tape over the dot, over the image. And I'm going to do that on both of these. When I run this through my die cutting machine between the platforms, I don't have to worry about this happening because there's nothing more frustrating than you got it all pretty and then it just messed up your whole thing. Your dies don't come out right. So I'm going to tell you right now, this is fantastic. You can go ahead and check that out under my craft room favorites. After you're done die cutting it, peel it from the front off and then peel it off the die. You can then keep this on your die cutting platform or right here on top of your little dispenser, and you can use it over and over and over again until you can't use it anymore. I love it because it's very economical and it can be reused. That makes me super happy. Let's talk about these images right here. I have them all colored and ready to go, but for those of you that are not familiar with the Stampin' Blends alcohol-based markers, this is one of my very favorite products. And I love to color. Is there anybody else who finds coloring therapeutic? I know I do. These markers are dual-ended and they're alcohol-based, which means you don't have to worry about any of those funky lines when you go over an area. It's going to leave flawless coverage. So you can choose what size tip that you want. Tonight, I'm feeling kind of brave, so let's go with that nice thick one. And you might look at this and think, well, where do you stop and start on this? Because the petal isn't finished. So let me just show you what I did. I went in here and I just kind of stroked in here very whimsically, okay? I wasn't even worried that if I covered the whole thing. So when I got to these little lines here, I kind of just added some color, all right? So don't let that worry you. And I'm just going to add a color here and a color there just so you can kind of get an idea. And I'm not being real neat about it. For the leaves, I really went off the deep end because obviously green would be the color of choice. But I thought, you know what? This is so bright and vibrant now because we've got that polished pink and we brought in that yellow designer paper. Let's add some Bermuda Bay. So this is kind of a blue-green color, and boy, is it pretty with this flower. Now, I love to start with my lightest shade of my Stampin' Blends first because that works well for me. You're going to experiment and find out what works well for you. But you'll recall that there's a darker shade to that polished pink. Now, let me show you what I'm going to do. These little areas right here where there's not a whole lot to color, you don't even have to fuss with. You can just kind of come over it like this, and you can just add a couple little lines here and there just to add some accentuation to those color areas. You don't have to be an artist to do this, but what you do need to do is if you want to come back and make this more blended for larger areas, you can do so, but you've got to let that alcohol base evaporate because if you don't, and you've got brand new markers like these, you're going to have a little bit of an alcohol bleeding effect. Now, you'll recall that there's also a darker shade for this. Now, I did fussy cut these leaves because there's no dye for this one. But I'm going to add a little dark over here to one side just because I think that's probably where it should go. I'm going to come back here to my lightest one. Watch this petal. I'm going to pull that dark into that light. And you are literally going to watch it before your eyes become less of a harsh line between those colors and appear more blended. That's what you're looking for. And again, is that important on all of them? No, but certainly works really well on larger images or larger areas. Here, we're going to do the exact same thing. So I'm pulling that dark into the light. Don't worry if it's not perfect. You don't have to cover the entire thing. And again, I went ahead and I die cut all of those. So let me put this off to the side because this is like the best. It's like a cooking show. You know, we're going to time lapse photography here. So we got some pink ones. There's those words we talked about. Here's some yellow ones. Here's some pink ones. And then I fussy cut my leaves. Now, listen, this is a great TV project. If you got school age kids, hand them a pair of safe scissors and let them go at it. This took me less than a minute, I promise. What we're going to do now is we're going to orchestrate putting this together. And I like to build my flowers first before I add them to my projects. And that is for good reason. I find that it's very difficult to build them while they're on the project, and I have a better idea of where the leaves should go. I'm using glue dots. If you're a liquid glue kind of person, you just go for it. Not good for me. I am so messy with this stuff. So I'm going to take one of my leaves here, and obviously this is going to go behind the flower. So I'm going to put the glue dot here at the bottom by pressing it here, pushing, and then lifting. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to add this like right around here somewhere. I left those centers white on purpose. One of you are probably going, Lisa, you are putting bling on this, aren't you? Well, you're just going to have to wait and see. I decided that I needed to be a little bit of a rebel today in the stamp studio. And I thought, you know what? White center is going to add a lot of credence to this card. And you'll see when it comes together. And then I'm going to add a second one here just for fun. So you're going to create those little bouquets of your flowers all before you start putting this on your project. Oh, you're probably wondering about this, right? This is called the Take Your Pick tool. When you're probably thinking, take your pick, that means you have choices. Yep, that's exactly right. You do have choices. And that's what I absolutely love about this product. This putty tip obviously will help you pick up these small pieces, including sequins. But wait till you see how I use this. And this is interchangeable. It's got stylus tools and a little spatula. Great for peeling off those dimensionals when you put them in the wrong places, because heavens knows I have done that. Let's go ahead and let's add this here to this last one. There we go. So now we got our flowers already. You're going to notice I have two here that don't have leaves. All right, we're going to push all of this off to the side and let's come back here to the card base. Now, intuitively, you would just stick your flowers on, but I want to teach you something really cool that gives this 3D card even more 3D. Are you ready? Okay. And it includes using this. I brought out my layering circles dies. It's one of my very, very favorites here in the studio because you get graduated sizes of the circles as well as the scallops. This is the smallest one. It's a 1-inch circle. So if you have a punch, that works as well. I took some scrap cardstock and I die cut 3 of these. So let me pull those out. And I did that ahead of time just to save a little bit of time with you. The other thing I did, as you're going to see, I scored them in the center. And I know one of you is going to ask, how in the world did you ever score something that simple? And that's because I have this. Watch. Lay this here at the half inch line on either side. Remember, this is a clear track. You can see right through it. So I'm lining up my little bumpy end here at the half inch. close. And then I scored, and that gave me this. And I did that on all three. I found by scoring them, it was easier for me because, quite frankly, this is really tiny and it's hard to fold it in half perfectly. So I used my scoring blade on my trimmer for that. I also have osteoarthritis, so that makes pinching really kind of difficult and painful for me. So that's just a great way for you to get those in halves. Now, let's work on the easy peasy part first. Let's pop this up. So remember, this was flat. I just popped this up. This now is going to be the very front of this card. This is where we can do the easy stuff. So I'm going to grab my dimensionals. Well, it's not, none of it's hard. This is just what I'm calling the easy stuff. So I'm going to put one dimensional on the back here. And then I am going to put this one right here. I'm going to take one of these other ones that doesn't have a leaf, and I'm going to add a dimensional to the back side of there. This now I'm going to overlap just a little bit. Now you want to be cognizant that you don't go too far out of here, because remember, we're going to put this in an envelope. And I know you're probably thinking, no way, but I promise we are. Let's go to this side and let's talk about visual interest. One of the things I've learned in my 23 years of card making is odd numbers are far more pleasing to the eye than even numbers. So keep that in mind when you're creating. Don't be afraid to create opposites. Do you see what I've done here? I've actually taken the pink from the outside and moved it to the inside. And I'm going to do the exact same thing now with the yellow. I'm changing positions because it's going to allow your eye to flow more freely. And then I'm going to tuck this one way behind here. I'm thinking, did I put my dimensional too close? Well, you know what? I'm just going to move it up. I think it's going to fit. All right. Now, remember these extra flowers? Oh, here comes the fun part. That's where these come into play. These are what I'm calling hinges. Now let's bring in the silicone craft sheet so I can show you how this works. Nothing about this card is hard. I promise you when you try it, you're going to be amazed. We are going to add adhesive to one half of this. Again, if you are into liquid glue, you're going to be really happy here. So I'm going to add my Stamp and Seal Plus. I want to make sure that nothing's hanging off the edge. I am going to take this now, and I'm going to add it to the back of this flower. I am making sure that the crease is going to be facing what I want to be to the inside of my card. Now, bear with me. That'll make sense in just a minute. So there we go. We've got a little hinge on here. Do you see it? This now is going to get adhesive on this side. So I'm going to choose to keep it folded, and I'm going to take my Stamp and Seal Plus. And I'm going to come right over here. Remember our card? We're coming up to here. I want this one smack dab in the middle. And I know you're probably thinking, really? Yeah, not intuitive, is it? And I did that for a reason. So I'm putting that here. Watch what we're doing with this next one, because this is where the magic comes in. I'm opening this up again. This is the second one. I'm putting Stamp and Seal Plus. I'm folding it in half. Here's my last flower, and we're going to flip that upside down. Remember, you want the crease to what will be the center of the card. So I'm going to put that here. And any overlap on here is even better. That's just a way to kind of brace the whole thing. And then I'm going to add a little adhesive to the other half. And again, you can use your liquid glue if that helps you. Let me just curl that extra adhesive back. Remember, the crease is here. Do you see it? Now, this is going to go right here. Let me show you. Here is the peak of that diamond fold. Do you see it? I am going to align this to this, and I'm doing my best not to get my head in your camera. All right, there you go. And I'm going to open this up, and I'm just going to press. Do you see it? But I'm going to show you what's going to happen. Do you see the aerial on this? It allows that flower to become front and center, and it pivots it, become 3D with the rest of the card. Now, here's some more magic. Are you ready? Here is the greeting. And if you're wondering about what, where do you sign the card, I got you covered on that as well. So we're going to do the exact same thing here. We're going to add a little bit more adhesive on that half. Again, knowing that this is going towards the center of the card. So I'm flipping it over. I'm centering it here on the back of my greeting. Now with those stitched areas, you might be really concerned about that kind of peeking through. But you know, it's white on white, so make sure your circles are the same color as your cardstock. That's an important tip for you. You're going to want to anchor this in the center of your greeting. Now what we're going to do is we're going to add a little bit of more adhesive to the tab. And this now, watch. You're probably going to think I'm crazy. I'm putting it here. But I got a tip for you that I learned today that I thought was slick. grab yourself any punch, slide it right down inside of here. This is going to give you a very stable area for you to get your finger in, okay? And I know that's going to be difficult to see, so I'm going to try to turn this for you. I'm leaving it on that silicone craft sheet so that it doesn't swivel. I am looking to put this folded edge right about here. So I'm going to come in here, and I'm looking down with my head, trying not to get it in your camera view. And then once I have it where I want it, I'm pushing against the punch, which is down inside of here. So I'm just going to pull that out. Look at, do you see it? Okay, ready? All right, we're almost done. We got to add an area for you to be able to add a greeting and then sign it, right? So I have a panel here. These are all part of the cutting dimensions. I use that exact same greeting from that same stamp set. Okay, just a different phrase. That now is going to go here on the back. Do you see how I've just popped this all down to make it flat? Oh, isn't this cool? I'm going to put this one on this side. I've got that envelope for you. Don't go away. And then I'm going to flip this over, and I've got two other samples. You're going to be wowed when you see them. I'm just going to prepare you right now. I am going to add this one to here. And you see how I added just a little bit of flower there? Okay, just to add a little continuity. All right, so this is how this card is going to go. This is going to come up, and then I'm going to open it up. So this is how the card is all finished. It is a wow. It is not hard. You got room now on the backside. They're going to display it. And I know you're wondering, how the heck are you going to get that in an envelope? Well, don't you worry, because I made one to coordinate. This is how it works. You are going to fold the base flat. You see how I'm pinching it? These panels go up and up, and then watch. This is going to fit perfectly inside your envelope. Do you see it? So you're going to go in sideways. This is why I want you to be cognizant of where your flowers are before you go ahead and you seal it. There we go. So then you've got your card here. I probably could have tucked that one on a little bit closer because you guys are all watching me. I got all excited. But isn't that fantastic? And I love those happy colors. Just think of all the cool things you can do with this. All right, here we go. We've got two others for you. Here is the next one. I've got an envelope for you too. This one uses the stamp set called Simply Succulents. And I actually use the bundle. This is a wow. So I did lots and lots of coloring, which I absolutely love. I find it really therapeutic. Look at that. Isn't that incredible? So here's our card. And then here is the backside of this one as well. Isn't that neat? Oh, love that. Panels come up. And you can see that this easily will fit in this envelope. You see how I gave you room here? So if you want to go a little bit taller, you've got ample room. So that's the second one. And then my last one is actually a stamp set that called Prince and Princess. So it comes down like this and it opens up and look at this. You're one of a kind. So I've got my swan. I added some flowers here. I brought in some of my other dyes and images from other stamp sets. And I would highly recommend thick basic white for this card. So we've got our little swan here and we've got our potted ones here. So we've got lots of images. Really hard to show a 3D card from an aerial view. And then, of course, this one here. And, of course, you're probably wondering about the swan. So I've got you covered there as well. Remember, these go up, and you can see that that's going to fit inside nicely. Don't forget, you've got to be able to download this because you want this. This is going to make your life super-duper easy. All your cutting dimensions for every single project and the supplies are all inside of here. I got you all covered. Now, let me turn the camera around. I've got some great things I want to share with you about shopping. Okay, I love being able to read your comments. Please tell me which was your favorite. I love to know. I try to create the samples vastly different to appeal to different tastes. All right, a couple things I want you to know before we get going. If you're like me and your wish list is getting longer and longer and longer because this amazing brand new annual catalog has you going, wow, there's something you need to know. Right now, there's an amazing promotion that if you happen to have a $250 product total, Stampin' Up! Is giving an extra $25 in Stampin' Rewards for free. So orders of $150 before tax and shipping automatically get what we call Stampin' Rewards. But if you get to $250 right now, they're actually adding to that by another $25. So typically, you would have $25 in Stampin' Rewards, but right now, during the promotion, they're giving you an extra $25, so they kind of doubled it, right? Who doesn't love free stuff? I know I do. And the best part about free is you can spend it on whatever you want, including the host exclusive products that you're not going to want to miss. And if you're also like me and your wish list is even bigger than that, there's even another deal that you might be interested in, and it's the custom starter kit. Now, I will tell you right now that it does, quote, here's my air quotes, make you a demonstrator, but I don't want that to freak you out. Please keep in mind that we love hobby paper crafters who want to earn a discount on the products that they purchase. And I would love to add you part of my stamping team. We are all over the U.S., as far as Hawaii is to Puerto Rico and Alaska and everywhere in between. And we have an amazing online community. And we'd love to have you a part of it. Now, the custom starter kit only in the month of May is going to allow you to choose any $155 of catalog product and only cost you $99. That kit ships absolutely free. That's another 10% savings. Only your local sales tax applies. And the best part? You get to shop at the 20% demonstrator discount for a trial run clear to the end of September and an additional 30 days, which takes you to the end of October, which is a pending month, so that you can just shop and have fun. There's lots more information on my website under the About Me or the homepage. I would love for you to be able to read that there or reach out to me and contact me through my website. I'd be happy to answer your questions. Just a couple ways for you to save some money and get those products that I know you're loving, because aren't these fantastic this year? Just a beautiful catalog. If you are interested in obtaining a catalog and you don't already have a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator, head over to lisastampstudio.com and click on catalogs. All the information is there. And while you're there, please sign up for my free weekly e-newsletter. I share a tutorial on that platform that is not shared anywhere else of my other platforms. It's exclusive to my newsletter, and I would love to include you. It's a no-frills email. I want you to do me a favor. If you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please do so. And make sure you click that little bell and the word all, because I'm coming back live with you next Monday, and I cannot believe we're nearing the end of May. Monday is May 24th, and I will be live right here at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And I hope that you will be here to join me for another fantastic card and more inspiration. Gina, thanks for all your moderating and help tonight. And thank you all for joining me. I look forward to seeing you next week. Have a blessed day.